And now it's time to record our first transaction. The first type of transaction we will learn how to record is depositing income. However, before we record any transactions, we should open up and save the report called the trial balance. The trial balance is your main financial summary. The trial balance shows the accumulated results of each account in the chart of accounts. So, the chart of accounts shows the name and the type of the account, but the report called the trial balance will show the name of any account that we actually used for transactions, and next to the name, it'll show the balance of the account, which is the accumulated results of all the transactions in that account. We will open up the trial balance by clicking on the top right of the main menu, Reports, Accountant and Taxes, Trial Balance. Right now, the trial balance shows nothing because we have not yet recorded any transactions. I'm recording this video in June of 2016. That's the reason why the trial balance opened with the date range May 1 to May 31 of 2016. Because by default, the trial balance opens up with the date range selected as last month. We need to fix this. Click on the arrow next to the word last month and get all of the different date range choices. Go down to the bottom and click and drag and scroll up and choose the very top choice, all. What we're doing here is we're asking QuickBooks to show us the results of all transactions regardless of date. Now that the trial balance looks the way we need it to look, we will then save it to the icon bar. Click View, Add Trial Balance to the icon bar, and then click OK. Now we have a shortcut to the trial balance right here in the icon bar. The first time you close the trial balance, you will get this message. Do you want QuickBooks to memorize this report? Well, we will click no because we don't need that. We already memorized it by putting it in the icon bar. However, this annoying message is going to keep popping up until we click this box. Don't display this message in the future. Now click no, and we don't have to worry about that message popping up. We're not using the chart of accounts, so we can close that too. Now when we click our shortcut to the trial balance, it opens up and it looks exactly the way we need it to look. Now here are the first three deposits of income that we're going to make. On July 1, we deposited $2,000 of income into Chase Bank and the transaction number was 8472. Well, how do we record that? Well, it's pretty easy. First of all, the transaction said it was Chase Bank. So you click the Chase Bank icon and the Chase Bank register opens up. The date was July 1. And again, I happen to be recording this video on June 26th. So after I click the date box, I have to click the forward arrow and click on the number 1, and QuickBooks will type into the date field for me July 1 of 2016. The transaction number is 8472. So when I click in the number field, I hit the back arrow to remove the number that QuickBooks suggested and type in 8472. Now, we can leave the payee blank because this is income and it does not require a name associated with the transaction. However, if the money's coming in and it's income that we earned, we click this arrow and we go to the only income account in our chart of accounts and choose income deposits. So we have the when, the what, we don't need who in this case, and we have the reason why we're depositing the money. The reason why is reflected in the account of the chart of accounts. We choose income because the reason we got this money is income. We must be very careful not to put the money in the payment column. If you accidentally save the money amount in the wrong column, it will be a problem to fix. It's fixable, but it will take a lot of time. Instead, be very careful and click only under the word deposit and type in the money amount. Now, you do not have to put a comma or a decimal point or a dollar sign. Just put the money amount in the row of the transaction under the word deposit. After you type the money amount, you click the word record. Congratulations. The register shows we have a $2,000 balance in our Chase bank account. And we also have $2,000 in income. We can close out the register and open our good friend, the trial balance, and you can see. Chase Bank now has a balance of $2,000, and the account called Income Deposits has a balance of $2,000. Stay with the video and stay with the story, and after we record the next two transactions, you will understand the purpose of the trial balance. The next transaction is June 2. Deposited $1,000 of income into the T&M Bank with slip number 2487 or 78. Okay, well, it says the next transaction is in the T&M account, so all we have to do is open the T&M register, put the date by clicking the calendar box, click on number 2 for June 2, make sure we copy the right number in 2478 in the number field, go back, 2478. Now, because it's income, we don't have to choose a payee. And the reason for the income is income deposits. This is what we earn from our service or product that we sell to the customer. Remember, it's still income, so be very careful to leave the payment column blank and type the money amount in the deposit column. Push tab to save the field. And congratulations, you now recorded your first income deposit into T&M Bank, and the register shows $1,000. But the most interesting thing is behind the register. Let's close it out. The trial balance shows that you made a $2,000 deposit into Chase Bank, you made a $1,000 deposit into T&M Bank, but your total income that you earned from your business is $3,000. And that's the purpose of the trial balance. Let's do one more for good measure. On June 3rd, we deposited another $500 of income into the Chase Bank account with slip number 9988. Can you predict what the numbers will be in the trial balance after we record this? Well, Chase Bank will increase by $500 and go up to $2,500. And the overall total income will increase by $500 and go up to $3,500. We open the Chase Bank register, put the date as June 3rd, put the transaction number as 9988. Again, because this is income, we don't need a payee. But the account that represents the reason why we got the income is income deposits. And again, be very careful to put it into the deposit column, $500. And at the moment you push the tab key on the left of your keyboard, you will have recorded the transaction and you see the new balance. If we close the register and look at the trial balance, the numbers are exactly what we expected. Chase Bank went up to $2,500 and income deposits went up to $3,500. And one final note. You can change any transaction anytime you want to anything you want. The results in the reports, including the trial balance, will change immediately. For example, if I went to the T&M register and I changed the money amount of this deposit, or I wanted to, let's say, I could click right in the field of the transaction that I want to change and make it anything I want. For example, I want to make this $5 million. Okay? As soon as I push the tab key on the left of the keyboard, which is the same as clicking the record button, I get a warning message. Are you sure you want to make this change? If you click yes, notice everything becomes huge. I now have $5 million in my T&M bank. When I close the register, look at the trial balance. I have $5 million in T&M Bank, and my income deposits went up to $5,002,500. Don't worry. You could always change it back to what it was as many times as you want. Let's go ahead and fix it. click the T&M register, click in the field of the item that you want to change, overtype what the wrong number is in favor of the right one, and then click record. Remember, you're going to get a warning message, so just click yes. Now notice all the numbers in the trial balance are back to where they should be. You don't only have to change the money amount. You can change any information in any field of the transaction. And when you click record, the results will correct themselves immediately.